In previous video, we have run a server in the Node MCU board and we accessed the server by using the IP address. So in this video, we are going to access the same Node MCU board by using Android mobile. So for that purpose, we require an app called Blynk. It can be downloaded freely from the internet. So by using this app, we can create buttons, sliders, joystick, and also display units. And also we can send and receive the data from this app. So first, we will see the software part and we will connect this bulb to the Node MCU board and we will control by using this app. So for that purpose, we have to download the ESP core, which we have seen in the previous video how to download ESP core. After downloading the ESP core, we have to include the Blynk library. So you can find the Blynk library in the Google for Blynk Arduino library and download the latest library available in the GitHub. So after downloading this zip file, we have to download in the zip. So after downloading the zip file, open Arduino software, go to sketch and click on include library and add zip library. Now select the zip file which you have downloaded. After that, click on open. So after importing this library, you will able to see the Blynk folder in the examples. Here you can see the Blynk. So if you are not seeing this one, the library has not imported into the software. So make sure that you should include correctly. Now by using one authentication key, unique authentication key, we are going to access this board. Open Blynk app in your mobile and click on create account. After that, login into your account. After that, you will get something like this. So this is the dashboard where you can add widgets like switches, sliders, joystick, display units, sensors, etc. So here I'm going to create one button. After creating one button, I'm going to control the light by using this button. For that purpose, click on create new project. We can give any project name. Here I'm going to give some LED and choose your hardware. We are using Node MCU, so this Blynk app will support different types of platforms or different types of microcontroller boards. So select Node MCU. So we are using Wi-Fi connection, so select Wi-Fi and click on create. So now this is the dashboard where we are going to add one button. So first click on the plus symbol and select button. So by using this button, we are going to access the light connected to the Node MCU. Here we connected the light to the D4. So we have to configure this button with the pin number. So for that purpose, select this one, go to pin, use digital. We will see the virtual pin concept later. First go to digital and select D4, and then it will ask for the type of button. It may be a push button or switch. So here I'm going to use it as switch, and you can give the labels like on, off. These are not mandatory. After that, go back. So now click on here and you will see a menu like this. See, here you will get authentication tokens. You have to place that authentication of this account in the Arduino program so that this app will identify your hardware. So for that purpose, here go to examples. We have already installed the Blynk library, so go to Blynk. After that, boards, Wi-Fi, we are using Wi-Fi board, so select Wi-Fi and select ESP standalone. You will get something like this, this program. So we have to modify this program so that we can get access to the Node MCU from this app. So first we have to place our authentication key and our network name and the network password. So you will get authentication mail, authentication key to your mail. If you click email all, it will send a number, some authentication token. You have to copy and paste it here. After that, give the Wi-Fi name or SSID. And also password. So copy the authentication ID which you got to your register email ID. So this is the authentication key. So simply click on upload. You need not to change anything in the program, just you have to give your Wi-Fi name, password and authentication key. That's it. So I'm going to upload the program to the board. So after uploading the program, click on play button here, then you will get access to control the Node MCU. Before that, make sure that your Node MCU should connect to your local Wi-Fi. To check that, go to serial monitor and wait here. You will get that your Wi-Fi board has been successfully connected to your Wi-Fi, your local network. So if it is not showing anything, simply change the baud rate here. Here the baud rate is by default 9600. Change it to 11500. It's the default baud rate for Node MCU board. So upload the program again. So if you are not seeing any data in serial monitor, simply click on reset button. Then this board will try to connect with the local Wi-Fi and it will print the IP address of that Node MCU. So here it is showing ready message. So we have access now to control the light connected to the Node MCU board. So simply click on play. Now can see, if you want to turn off, so like this we can control the light connected to the Node MCU board. Not only a light, we can add a slider. By using this slider, we can control motors Also, we are having a timer joystick. By using the joystick, we can make an internet controlled robot. In the next video, we are going to see how to make a robot which can be controlled through internet by using this joystick, which can be controlled from anywhere in the world. So these are the widgets we are having. By using these widgets, we can do any type of IoT project. So this is the basic project where we are connecting only one bulb and one button.